Well, we are on to number 6 of Korn's catalog. Take a look in the mirror. What's going on, ladies and gentlemen, Cyberland? Come back to another album review from Korn's catalog. This time we're on to their 6th album. Take a look in the mirror. So, I gotta say, when this album dropped, I didn't know it was dropping. Like, it was, I think I had been listening to Korn, but it wasn't being advertised. It really wasn't. Knowing what I know now why. But at the time, for us fans, it was just kind of like, boom, here it is. And we just had Untouchables. I thought, what's going on with that? Come to find out, the record label pretty much was done with Korn. They felt like they made as much money as they could. They really didn't think they were going to make any more with the band. So they just had them, you know. The band, I guess, came to the conclusion they were done with Epic Records 2, or Immortal, however you want to call it. And they were just like, fuck it. Put the shit out. And that's really what it was. It was really just an album that had hardcore elements before Untouchables, but it was just a rushed effort. It was like Life is Peachy 2, but except I felt that Take a Look in the Mirror was a step down from Life is Peachy for sure. Actually, it was a step down from all the albums up until this point. And the reason being was because the tracks were just short. Some of them were good. Some of them just were like, there wasn't any tracks I didn't like. It wasn't like Make Believe from Untouchables, but they were just there. They really weren't memorable. They were enjoyable, but they weren't. The material really wasn't anything they had done up until this point that was that great. It's not a terrible album. It just was just a there album. Like, let's just fulfill our contract and put this out. That was the vibe that it gave. The good thing is, you know, there was a song on there called Live, and Korn had originally done that song way before the first album, and fans had always requested that to re-release it or something. They always wanted to hear a better rendition of it, and the band did. So that is one of the highlights of the album. And so I remember I was doing something on the internet, and I just said, let me go check out some of that Korn. And then all of a sudden, this flashy website pops up, and it's, I was like, what the hell? And it had this spooky, like there was like an old house in the background with a crow and all this stuff. And I was like, what is this? Is this a new album? And it was. And I was just kind of like, what the hell? Like, what's going on here? There was like really no announcement about it. Like, nobody was talking about it. It was just weird. And the album was supposed to drop. Normally back then, albums would drop on a Tuesday. But what happened was the album had leaked. So that following Tuesday was supposed to come out. They bumped it up into that Friday. And I just went to Best Buy and I picked it up. But I had already heard the tracks on the website. The website made it to where you could go through all the tracks. I was surprised. Like, I didn't get the same vibe from the first 5 albums with it when I heard it. But it was cool. It was entertaining. You know, it had some decent music on it. It's just, you know, the Nas. I remember I said there were any more rapper things, but there was. Nas was on a song called "Play Me." That was on here. But that felt like they just. That track felt like Korn and Nas never collaborated each other. That sounded like they took Nas vocals and spliced it together with a Korn track. It didn't feel like Children of the Corn or Camel Toe. It just gave this vibe like the record label took, it was just a track that Nas had done for something but he hadn't utilized it. And they just said, hey, can we have these lyrics? Let's utilize the record label. I felt that track was the record label. That wasn't the band. The band was just like, they like Nas, but it was just kind of like, we're done with you guys. You're done with us. Let's just put it out there. It wasn't something where it was anything outside of that. It's cool, but it's not a memorable track. It just felt like the record label made that track, the band didn't make that track. My top five tracks for right now, Break Some Off, Alive, Did My Time, and Run With The Sun. I felt Did My Time, you know, it's not my favorite track. It really encompasses, I guess, the overall, how the album is, I guess is one way to describe it. And of course, we have the bagpipes and one of the songs called Let's Do This Now. But otherwise, it's just a bare album. My rating for it, is it a 6 out of 10? Yes, sirs. I can listen to it, but I wouldn't. It's not on my. It's not an album that I'm just going to run to listen to, whereas some of their later stuff, I'll listen to that before this. And of course, the 5 albums before it. But there are some albums we're coming up to that I'll listen to this before I listen to those. So, yeah. Also, this was also the time where my palate for Korn pretty much took a nosedive. It's unfortunate, but looking back on it, it's because this was the last album where Head left. He had a lot of stuff going on, as we found out later down the road, and he needed to get his shit together and get his stuff straight, and being with the band just wasn't going to cut it. So he left, and due to him leaving, this period for me with Korn just took a nosedive. I just wasn't moving forward. I wasn't as interested in the band as I had been up until this point. And the main reason why is because it shows in the music, but I'll get more into that later. So with that being said, I wouldn't say this should be a go-to album for you, but if you like what Korn has done up until this point, then check it out. You may be disappointed, you may like it. I'd be surprised if you're going to say you really love it. Just because of what I described in it. It's not a bad album, it's just there. There's nothing, it's just not memorable. It has a couple tracks that are cool and stuff, you know, but that's as far as it goes. So, it's good music.